top?
Oh.
Isn't it? Or not?
No. If somebody cracked the block, that's why it's glued.
Huh?
There's part of the block. That's why there's silicone stuck in it. Somebody glued it back together.
I don't know, I just always had a fascination with them. I just always wanted to know what made them tick and what made them go. And my dad was not an auto mechanic, so he couldn't give me the answer. So.
It's interesting when I walk up to the car and tell them that I can fix it, but that I'm blind. And they just, you know, most of the time I've been also been at the point where the people that I've stopped to help are not auto mechanics. So they just sort of look and go, well, I guess if you can fix it, you go ahead. And it just is, they've just let me do it. But yeah, I'm sure that the looks are, it would be interesting to see their facial expressions, particularly when they're fixed. Well, I was always legally blind since birth, and I went to 12 years of high school, 2 years of tech, or 1 year of tech school, and 2.5 years at Automotive Training Center. And somewhere around the age of, I'm going to say 24, is when I started noticing what little bit I had was also leaving me.
Particularly when all my eyesight went, I couldn't even, you know, there was no faking it then.
He does everything by feel and memory. He's got his whole property stepped off, so he pretty much knows exactly where he's at any point in time out in his yard. And even on my property, he kind of has a feel for the way things lay. You kind of worry for him because every once in a while he's bumping into things, and I kind of chuckle to myself, but he's chuckling too, or cursing, and just keeps on going, so that's pretty cool.
I mean, it's like the block, right? It's all metal.
Metal.
You get on it, don't you?
Damn it, that tightened up.
Huh?
That's the hole. I said that tightened up. That's the hole that was going in. That should have worked.
But yeah, Wayden works on our cars all the time. If there's something sounds funny in the car, I'll call Wayne and say, hey Wayne, take a ride with me. I need you to listen to this noise in my car. And he'll go for a ride with me. And most of the time he can tell just by listening to the car what's wrong with the car. He's been right on every time. He can hear a starter problem, he can hear a battery problem, he can hear all kinds of things going on with the car that you and I might not ever know until we took it to a mechanic. So he can, just by riding in the car and listening to it, he can a lot of times diagnose what's wrong with the cars.
We kind of like the idea that he keeps an eye out for us, and when he notices something deficient on our cars, he'll let us know. And he happened to pick up on the fact that the tires needed to be replaced.
I brought the trash can down. And I don't know, I'm always touching stuff, and I just happened to touch the rear tire, and it was, you know, it was kind of bald, so I walked around the whole car and checked them all for her, and called her up and told her that it's time to get new ones.
He was absolutely right. Tires had about 52,000 miles on them, which is way more than they should have on them, and so we took his advice and got new tires on the truck.
You know, I don't think I ever really wanted to run my own business, but I think I got to the point where I didn't have any choice.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't go anywhere else. You know, nobody really wanted to hire me because of the things that I can't do or the things that I need assistance doing. So that I just sort of made my own destiny, you know what mm-hmm. I mean? I put yeah. the people around me that were working for me and doing what I wanted them to do rather than me, people wanting, trying to figure out what I could or couldn't do.
It was a service station. It was running 24 hours a day with a repair shop. We had three bays and a small mini mart in the front. Uh-huh. And I ran that until, I guess until 1993 is when I partially got out. 95, I pretty much got totally out. When I had that time and that and some other changes that I made in my life, we just went back into hot rodding.
Wayne does a little bit of everything, but his primary job is to, he's an automobile mechanic, and a top-notch mechanic at that.
This one's won the most awards of all of them. My others that I've had in the past have, you know, spotty, but my other 55 Chevy won a couple. But this one has won the most of them. Won best of show in a couple places, top 25, top 50. Top 10. It's latest. The last one was at the, which was really a cool one, was at the Northeast Nationals in Burlington, Vermont. It got best Chevy in a Chevy, which means Chevrolet motor and a Chevrolet car. Yeah, if you don't like it, I don't think you can do it. You couldn't do this if you didn't like it.
You know, and I've always had to prove myself. It's always been that way. And I've always felt like I can't make a mistake, because if I do, I have a perfect reason. You know, people say, what do you expect? So.
That's pretty amazing in itself.
Different cars and go different places and be able to just see cars I haven't seen, meet the people.
Yeah.
It's as much about meeting the people as it is about the cars after a while.
The cars are the common bond, and we just, you know, meet people and you park next to them and start talking to them, and the next day you park next to somebody else and the conversations just continue. And I've got friends all over the country now because of this, and yeah, it's a great hobby.